guys, my dad's going to show me how to set up a Windows 10 without a Microsoft ID.
Okay, we're going to go ahead and fire up the Intel Compute Stick for the first time. So we're using an HDMI video capture to record this, since when you first start up a computer, it's not going to have any screen recording software on it. And so this is the point where you would hook up your mouse or keyboard. And so we're using an integrated mouse and touchpad that has a single dongle with it, so that only uses up one of the two USB ports on the Intel Compute Stick. And so go ahead and click on Next when you have your keyboard installed. And right here we're going to do your location data. So for us it's going to be the United States. And English, US, and go up and set your time zone and hit Next. Here's your legal stuff, hit Accept. Now this part is optional. You can go ahead and hook up to a Wi-Fi network. This compute stick does not have a Ethernet port, so hooking up to the internet, your only option is to use Wi-Fi. So this is the crucial part. You need to get this right. We want to customize. We don't want to use express settings. We want to customize.
What are all these things?
These are the various ways that Microsoft collects computer operational data and sends it to various sources on the web. And so I don't find anything here worth keeping. I go ahead and uncheck everything. So uncheck those. You can read through those. If there's something that's important to you, you can go ahead and keep it. Okay, this is the part where it expects you to either create or enter your Microsoft user account information. So at this point, we're going to skip this step because we don't want a Microsoft user account. We just want a local user account. So at this point, go ahead and hit a username. And we're just going to use media because this is just going to be a media player. And if you don't enter any password data, it will just make it boot up without requiring a password. So this is the Cortana part. I don't use Cortana. You can if you want. Okay, so it came up with this Intel remote keyboard. You can go ahead and update that as required, but I haven't found the need to yet. So now we're going to go to the Start menu and get rid of everything here. If there's something that you want to keep, go ahead, but I have never found a need to keep any of these things here. So go ahead and click all those things off, just right click and unpin from Start menu.
What about Office?
Well, I don't use Office, I use LibreOffice. It's the open source go-to software to replace Microsoft Office. Okay, and so that's pretty much all you need to know to get a Windows 10 system set up without using a Microsoft online ID. You can just set it up with a local ID and use it for a media computer.
You should click here, not here. But we don't want to be herded into, is it Microsoft or is it Windows? Can't remember.